I want to greet all in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, the one who seated on the throne of grace and the throne of mercy. I have a quote here from Sophie Loren. She says, when you are a mother, you are never really alone in your thoughts. A mother always has to think twice, once for herself and once for her child. Close quote. Happy Mother's Day to all mothers who are here, all mothers who are at home. The Bible says, I was glad when they said to me, let us go into the house of the Lord. And I want to believe that right there in your home, where you are sitting, where you are in your house, your warm house, because of lockdown, because of COVID-19, we were asked to stay home. But I want to believe that the Spirit of the Lord is there. I want to believe that the church is there, because you are the church. Happy, happy, happy Mother's Day once again. And when I say mothers, I'm talking about bo auntie, I'm talking about bo mamukholo, bo mamalume, bo rakhadi, le bo matswale. Happy Mother's Day to you. You sisters who are taking care of your little sisters, happy Mother's Day. All your little brothers, happy Mother's Day. Hallelujah. And anyone who is taking care of someone in the family, anyone who is a manager in the family, house executive, I want to salute you this morning. And I want to say we love you. I want to say indeed you are really loved. Always love your mother, because you will never ever get the other mother. You can't replace your mother. And at the same time, I want to acknowledge those who are saying, Pastor D, I don't have a mother. My mother passed on. Yes, your mother passed on, but you are loved. Know that God is with you. He said, I will never leave nor forsake you. He's a father to the fatherless. And I want to believe that he can be a mother to the motherless. And of course, some of you, even though your mother has passed on, God has blessed you with Mama Zala, Mama Tswale. She is your mother. Send her a message and just say, Mama Tswale Waka, I love you and happy Mother's Day. I'm proud and I'm glad and I'm blessed that I'm still having my own mother, Sophie Mungwaketsi. She's 72 years old. She's my pride. She's my protector, my provider. I can say it. Even today, I'm still asking her money. You won't believe it. I would go to her and say, Mami, ke kopa tjhelete from ele ya sasa ele. And she will always give me, because I'm her little baby girl. She calls me baby. And that is why we love our mothers like this. Being a mother is not about being perfect. I want to repeat this again to you, mothers. Being a mother does not mean you have to be perfect. It's about your best love to your children, giving your best to your children, giving what you have to your children. Today, I want to speak to us as mothers all over the world, all over South Africa. For I know that you are here with me on your Facebook, and I know that you have tuned in. And our topic this morning is noble mothers. I know that the Bible speaks about a noble woman, but I want to say today, noble mothers. And my scripture today is from Proverbs chapter 31, verse 29. The Bible says, many women do noble things, but you surpass them all. Can I repeat it? Many women do noble things, but you surpass them all. Can I try to read it in Zulu? The Bible says in Zulu, verse 29, Baningi abafazi abakhutheleyo kepha wena ubadlula bonke. Baningi abafazi Can I say this time? Baningi abo mama abakhutheleyo kepha wena ubadlula bonke. Lord, bless your word this morning. In the name of Jesus Christ, we have prayed. Amen. The word noble from the dictionary, it speaks about someone who has high morals, someone who is always honest, someone who is charitable, the person who is generous, someone who is helpful, someone who is great, elevated, and dignified. And today I know that I'm talking to mothers who are generous. Naturally, mothers are generous. That is why we are able to go and help other kids, other children. We are able to adopt. We are able to sit with our nephews, with our nieces. We are able to sit with people that are not our biological children. Because generally, we are generous. We are great. We are dignified. You can go around and you will see women and mothers who are dignified. So continue to be like that. That is part of being a mother. When we speak about the word surpass, it speaks about exceeding. It speaks about outdoing, outshining, to be on top. There's this advert that I like. It says, I'm not under, but I am on top. Women, mothers, can I say this morning? You are not under, you are on top. Meaning, you are somebody. The Bible says you are created in the image of God. Therefore, don't allow anything to put you under. Don't allow anyone to say you are a tail. You are not a tail, but you are on top. Because Jesus, our God, loves you so much. And you are the children of God and a child of God. And created in His own image. So mothers, can I say something this morning? Don't focus on negativity. People are so negative outside there. People are so negative. They like to say negative things about people. They are there to destroy others. They are there to destroy our lives. There are people who are there. Their lives is to destroy the dignity of other mothers. But I want to stand before you this morning and say, don't allow them. Don't put your focus on women like that, on mothers like that, even on men who are like that. You are not under, but you are on top. You are somebody. You are created in the image of God. Don't allow anyone to put you down. Don't allow these people who like to put other people down. Don't allow them. You are somebody and you are loved by God. As a noble mother, I want to urge you this morning, continue to love yourself. When you love yourself, you'll take care of yourself. The Bible says, love your neighbor as you love yourself. You cannot love somebody if you don't love yourself. You start with yourself first. You take care of yourself. You take care of your body. You take care of your face. You take care of everything. Therefore, and after that, you will be able to take care of the other person, your neighbor. So you love yourself first, then you can give out love to other people. Take care of your family. That is us, abo mama. You need to take care of your family. Continue to do that. Continue to display order. We don't want to see mothers who are out of order. Those mothers who are standing at their gates the whole day and they are talking, you don't know what they are talking about. You don't have to be like that mother. You need to be focused. You need to have a dream. Mothers are people of dream. They are dreamers. So I want to say, oh, you dreamers, display order all the time. Continue to pray for your families. Your families, they need your prayer. Cover them with your prayers. Build one another. You cannot be a mother and destroy other mothers. That is why we don't believe in mothers, or we don't acknowledge mothers who are gossipers. Because if you are a gossiper and you are a mother, you are not a light to the world. You need to build other women. You need to go to a woman and another mother and say, stand up. You cannot laugh at other mothers. You cannot do that because bari kasizulu le mini leza naguwe. So you can't do that because you know that we are what we are because of the grace and the mercy of God. Be focused. Continue to be focused. Continue to set healthy boundaries. Bona, as a mother, say no. When you say no, you must mean no. When you say yes, you need to say yes. Your east should be east. Your west should be west. Your north should be north. You cannot be a confused mother. You can't. You don't qualify to be like that. But I thank you that as I'm talking to you, I know that I'm talking to mothers who are executive, house executives. Hallelujah. Make sure that you avoid to make mistakes, unnecessary mistakes. And as a mother, can I say to you again, continue to have fun with your children. Enjoy your children. Play with them. Be happy with them. I like this thing of lockdown. I see so many mothers are playing with their children. Mothers are doing things that are good with their children. And I want to say, go on. Viva, mama. Viva. That is a good thing. You are blessed and you are highly favored. That is the message. Noble mothers, they know that I need to be focused all the time. Noble mothers will never destroy other mothers. Noble mothers will never destroy their children. Noble mothers will never destroy the society. Noble mothers will never destroy marriage of the other person. Noble mothers will always lift up other mothers because God is there and He's there all the time. So I want to urge us this morning and say, let us continue to be noble. Let us continue to exceed in whatever that you are doing. As you clean your house, make sure that you exceed in cleaning your house. Outshine. I'm not saying compete. I'm not saying have pride. I'm just saying when you do things, do them the way mothers can do them. You know, I have families and other in my families are mothers, and I can see when we do things, we exceed. Others exceed in cooking, others exceed in cleaning, others exceed in reading, others exceed in professions, others, we exceed it, and we don't compete, but you are saying we are mothers and we are noble and we are excellent, we are helpful, we are great, we are dignified. Baningi abo mama. And much as we have many mothers, can I challenge you, Oguti? Even if abo mama baningi, ba aba kona, aba hlala nathi. Even if bakona, mina ngithi kuwe kepha wena, but wena, you need to know that you can surpass them all. Ungaba dlula bonke ngokulunga ngokuthanda abantwana bakho ngokuthanda umuzi wakho ngokuthanda abanye abantu. To be a respectful mother, continue to do that. Noble mothers are role models. Continue to be role models. When people talk about you, they need to say, I will love to be like this mother. I always say, I look at my mother and I say, I want to be like my mother. There are so many things that she went through, and I can see, I saw her arising. I saw her standing up. I saw her taking care of us, even when our father was not there. And I look at her and I say, I want to be like my mother. My mother is a super mother. And I want to believe that, Nani Ekaya, you are super mothers. Noble mothers are mothers who are creative. Mothers who are supportive. Mom is a blessing that no one can replace. We'll never replace you, mothers. Even husbands, even fathers, even children know that they will never replace you. Can I say this to you? Love is the one of the ingredients that make the family stick together. Let us continue to love our mothers, because when we love them, when we respect them, when we cherish them, they will continue to shine. They will continue to be on top. They will continue to take care of us. they will continue to love us more. They will continue to pray for us. They will continue to take care of the house. They will continue to love our fathers. Mothers, happy Mother's Day. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord shine His face upon you. May you continue to be a blessing to the society. May you continue to be a blessing to your family. May you continue to be a blessing to your husband. May you continue to be a blessing to your Mama Zwala. May you continue to be a blessing to everybody who is surrounding you. We love you so much and we are praying for you. We will never be the same without our mothers. I am what I am because of my mother. My sister is what she is because of my mother. And I know that even you at home, you are what you are because of your mother. Mothers, be blessed. We love you so much. The world says we salute you. This is your day. Enjoy it in your home. May the Lord keep you in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Be blessed and be blessed till we meet again. Got another Mother's Day next day 2021. God bless you. Amen.